How can you miss someone you've never met?
As an overthinker, if I message you late at night, it's not to be annoying or clingy. It's because when I'm by myself at night, that's when my thoughts are the loudest. And I message you because you help keep them quiet.
It is incredibly frustrating being the girl who falls so easily for others, struggling so much to love herself. It gets lonely, and I'm not going to lie, it's really hard because I can't expect to get better when I am constantly relying on love from others to hold up the parts I have never even loved on my own. Only being able to inhale when someone says I love you, because whenever I'm alone it feels impossible to breathe. And every time they take that love away, every time they change their mind, decide I'm actually not worth it anymore, they pull the tape so carefully, holding me together like a ripcord, and all of those things in the back of my mind become true. All of my deepest insecurities validated, like they're in my ear whispering, you were right all along. I look into their eyes, turned to stone, as their words take a sledgehammer to my heart and I shatter. So I've built this box with walls and splintered pieces of my heart that I couldn't quite get to fit again. Climbed inside, and I'm slowly running out of room to breathe.
I love how parents think that being a teenager these days is so easy. It's not difficult, it's not stressful. You see, if we tell them leave us alone, they think it's all because of our phones. You're so addicted to those phones, so they take them away. Or if we fail a test, they think it's because of our friends, so they blame our friends and they tell us they're bad influence. Stop hanging out with them. Or if we get a bad grade, they think it's because we didn't study as much, we didn't try as hard. What you need to understand is that we don't fail tests because we want to. We don't make stupid mistakes because we like to. We don't lash out or want alone time because we feel like it. It's because we need it. It's because the whole outside world, like our friends and schools and teachers, they pressure us. And our parents, we don't need them to judge us. They tell us, when we were kids, we get it. When you were kids, your life was perfect. It was filled with rainbows and sunshine and little kids running around happy. But it's 2021. Times have changed and we have changed. Understand that.
I'm careful about the amount of effort I've put in, right? When it comes to like conversations, not because I don't want to have a conversation, but because I'm scared of getting attached.
Here's to the night I stood alone. To the night I cried so hard I couldn't breathe. To the night I prayed to God for you to come back to me. And of course, to the night when you never even looked back.
Honestly, I am not the friend you're gonna hear from on a daily basis, but if you need me, I'll be there.
I fucked up. Like I always do. So now I'm all alone.
You know what the saddest thing is? It's that the nicest, kindest people will never believe a single compliment that they've ever been given. But they'll believe every insult that's ever been said to them. So let that sink in for a little bit.
It's like within the past week, like I just am so burnt out with life that nothing literally makes me feel excited.
Deserve someone who can't wait to talk to you and spend time with you, get to know you, fall in love with you. Please stop settling for half-hearted, lukewarm, hesitant, and indecisive. It is so much better to be alone than to be with someone who makes you feel alone.
It doesn't matter. It's in the past.
Yeah, but it still hurts.
Oh, yes, the past can hurt. But the way I see it, you can either run from it or learn from it.
Oh, I'm in pieces, it's tearing me up. But I know a heart that's broke is a heart that...
I can't hold my body, touch it, stare at it. Oh, I will never understand how everyone else just doesn't want to punch their reflections. Shatter that rectangular distorter into a million pieces. Give me all the bad luck. I mean, I don't think the next 7 years can get any worse, really. And this body has done nothing wrong, and yet I punish it. I send it to bed without dinner. I make it sit in isolation. I critique every lump and bump and crevice. I do not think there is a single part of my body I can say I love. I cannot even use the word like.
I'm telling you, I'm fine. I've never been happier. See? That's a smile, right? Showing teeth, eyes all crinkly.
A woman could be in the worst position possible, and the only words you'll hear from her is, "I'll figure it out." And I promise you, she will find a way. She might have a trillion breakdowns, but she will get through it. To all the women, your hard work does not go unnoticed. Keep striving.
Every day, I'm not enough, but I still stay.